The United States set to take steps to prevent American chip makers from using loopholes in the government's curbs in selling semiconductor chips to China. The new rules will block some AI chips that fall just under current technical parameters while demanding companies to report shipments of others. The restrictions have kept chipmaker NVIDIA from shipping two of its most advanced AI chips to Chinese customers. The latest crackdown on tech exports to China coincides with U.S. efforts to ease tensions between the world's two largest economies. Several senior members of the Biden administration have met their Chinese counterparts in recent months, and the latest round of restrictions could complicate the diplomatic effort. Moving on, Finance Chief Benjamin Diokno pitches ease of doing business efforts in the Philippines with multinational banks at the recently concluded meetings of the International Monetary Fund and the World Bank. That story and more from Denise Dinsai. Denise.
Hi, Stanley. Now, Secretary Diokno met with executives of Citi, HSBC, and Bank of America, where he shared updates on the Philippines' growth outlook. Citi lauded Manila's thrust for increased digitalization in retail payments and public financial management. HSBC, meanwhile, reaffirmed its long-standing partnership with Manila and talked about exploring more investments in sustainable infrastructure and energy transition. For its part, the Bank of America said it believes the Philippines' growth prospects will remain strong in the long term despite a challenging external environment. Also from Diokno's overseas meetings, Japanese banks showing strong interest in investing in the Philippines with a focus on renewable energy and sustainable tech infrastructure, among others. Secretary Diokno led discussions with Japan's biggest lenders, including the Japan Bank for International Cooperation and Mizuho Securities. The finance department says the meetings in Morocco seek to sustain talks with Japanese partners following President Marcos's visit to Tokyo in February this year. For our numbers that matter this Monday, $3.1 billion. That's how much money overseas Filipino workers sent home in August. Data from the central bank show this figure is 2.8% higher year on year. Meanwhile, for the first 8 months of the year, cash remittances from OFWs reached $24 billion, representing a 2.9% increase year-on-year. President Marcos vows support for cooperatives to boost the country's agriculture sector. Marcos spoke Monday at the celebration of the National Cooperative Day in Malacañang. There, he stressed the need to further organize and consolidate farmers' organizations and cooperatives and to ensure that they are well-funded and well-managed. The president, who is also the concurrent agriculture chief, assured his support to the Cooperative Development Authority, the agency tasked to promote the viability and growth of cooperatives nationwide.
Cooperative movement is very closely related to agriculture. Because for the simple reason that we need to consolidate our farmers, maliliit lang sila, they're one. Pag isa lang yan, walang nakikinig dyan. Pero pag marami-rami na yan, kahit na yung congressman ninyo, yung governor ninyo, yung mayor ninyo, makikinig na sa inyo. Dahil marami na ang cooperative, the cooperative has some influence. A cooperative movement will organize the cooperatives para maging 150 hectares, 200 hectares, 250 hectares. Yun, yung pinakamalalaking makinara, magagamit na natin yun. Worthwhile na yun. Imbis na kuliglig na lang ang ginagamit natin, kailangan yung malaki para mabawasan natin ang presyo, cost of production, at mas magandang quality, at mas magandang hanap buhay ng farmer.
Manila's trade chief urging the country's micro, small, and medium enterprises to take part in the growing halal industry. Secretary Alfredo Pascual made that pitch during the signing of a memorandum of understanding between the DTI and DKPO Fulfillment Company, Inc., a non-interest financing service to address the development of the local halal industry. The DKPO was founded with the purpose of empowering MSMEs through its Purchase Order Fulfillment Program, a proprietary system built for sustainable business performance. Pascual emphasized the development of the halal industry is expected to generate 230 billion pesos in halal trade and investments and create over 120,000 jobs in 5 years.